All right, let's go. Another night, another slam dunk of a record just dropped from Nathan Dawe. He's not letting up, I'm telling you now. This time, it is way too long collabing with Amory. You two together, fire, what's happening?
I'm good, how are you?
Good, good. Good to see you, Nathan. How are things?
Yeah, not good. Not good, really good.
great start. Here we go.
No, everything's great, trust me. Really, really cool. Just getting ready for the lifting of lockdown, and I'm hoping this song is going to bring everyone joy and happiness for when that happens. And you know, it's a really good kind of on topic record, and I think, you know, Amory and most that both sound amazing on it, and I'm just so happy it's finally out to the world.
I'm so excited. We'll dive into that in a little bit. Annalisa, Mary, hello, good to see you.
Good to see you too.
You've been like the busiest bee of them all. You're an overachiever. One of those ones that I had to mute on socials because all I've done in the last 4 months is like eat my body weight in chocolate, and you're out there doing The Voice, doing so many tracks, being on Bake Off. Like, can you calm down, please, sis?
I know. And to think at the start when I was like, this is the worst thing ever, I thought that I was just going to be doing nothing for like the whole of COVID, and it turns out I did actually more than ever. So yeah, it feels good.
I love this. All right, we're on for this new record, Nathan. You're good at a little tease of your new records. It's as if you did like a marketing module for A-level, because you get it ready to go. You planned it out.
I am a teaser, I'll be honest.
So when did this opportunity come up to get together, get with Amory? Why was it her that had to be on this record?
I just felt that her voice suited it, and I think it was just the obvious choice for me, really. So, you know, when we sent it across, I was sitting there, fingers crossed. And Amory loved it, didn't you, Amory? Like,
yes.
It was great to get the great feedback. And then, you know, we thought, let's introduce a rap element, and we got most like on it, and it just all naturally fell together in a really nice way. So just so happy that it's come together the way it has.
I mean, that's the thing, Amory. I'm loving any like slightly garage feeling fire you're on, but this one, yeah, you did good.
I know. And I met Nathan, we were in the studio a little while back, and his energy was so great. And we were always planning on doing a song. I actually have a couple of the ones we've done that are going to be on my album. So I loved working with him. And then when this song came about, I was like, because when I get sent songs, I'm a bit like, ooh, what's this going to be like? And it's very rare that I connect with them, you know? And as soon as I listened to this song, I was like, this made me feel better. Like, as soon as I heard it. So I was recording it in my living room the next day, I think.
It was quick turnaround. Yeah, it was good.
Yeah.
That's what you want. That is, you know, when you instantly connect with a song, when it comes through, like, I'm just saying as well, I'm just imagining it in, you know, everyone else out there, I imagine these kind of songs in a club, but like, there's a very kind of specific club, very kind of specific time that you're going to be hearing this at.
I think, like, I mean, does it make you smile when you hear it?
Damn, because it does.
Yeah. I feel like everyone that has heard it, I just watch them and they smile. And then, you know, 10 minutes later, they'll be humming the melody. And I'm just like, it's just the way that with everyone that's heard it, you know, that I've been around recently. So it's like, I think that tells you that it's a really connecting record. So fingers crossed everyone continues to love it.
Yes. I mean, also, Nathan Dawe, how do you do it? 18 months, you've got like massive smasher, massive smasher, massive smasher. Like, what? Where does this come from? Honestly.
It's just having time, to be fair. We were talking about this earlier today, and like, I think with lockdown, obviously it's been awful for everyone. And but I think for creatives and artists like ourselves, it's just enabled us to have so much more time than we usually do to put into our craft and create music. And that's what we've done. And I think that's just testament to the success we've both had in lockdown. I think we've had a lot more time to really, really get our teeth into the art. And that's what has been key, I feel.
Yeah, I feel it's like one of those things, you know, when you've got nothing to do, so you do something.
So it just comes up. Yeah. Just all you got to do is just sit in bed all day. So we just thought, maybe I'll make some music.
Yes. Speaking of which, lockdown's going to ease. I mean, hopefully very soon, as long as we all still do our bit. Hey, we got tour dates this summer. It's happening. We got tour dates in autumn. We got shows to look forward to. Anne-Marie, I love the fact that you just are sharing every single person that books a ticket to your show. I feel like you're going to like personally greet them in and seat them as an usher. Like, that's mad.
I think I might. I might actually do that. I want to get right in to every element of being at a show again. I might wait with them outside while we're waiting for the doors to open. I'm just going to be there from the start to the finish. I can't wait for it. It's going to be the best ever.
It's going to be so good. Way too long. Tour coming in November. Nathan, I've already kind of like pinned out my Friday in Manchester to come.
Like, good lad.
That's so cool. Birmingham sold out like that.
Yes. It always does. Birmingham's like just showing so much love. And, you know, like, I think, 3,000 tickets in like 3 hours, which was just mental. And it's, that's my hometown, like my homecoming. I just cannot wait to just bring the party back to Brum, because they've supported me from day one, and I want to give them the chance of seeing their favourite artist on stage in Birmingham and just giving them a bit back, really, for all the support they've shown. So I'm just so super excited. And for the rest of the UK and the Ireland dates, it's going to be amazing to see the reaction of everyone's faces when the music comes on. It's going to be sick.
And I mean, I do have to say, I feel like I want to be really sensitive about this because Anne-Marie is here, but congrats on the Brit nomination / Anne-Marie. I don't know what was going on with that Brit voting panel, because something was going wrong.
Thank you so much. Anne-Marie's had a fair share.
I've been nominated too many times, I think. So they're just like, let's just allow it for this year.
Give everyone else a chance.
I'm just saying now, throw your hat in the ring for some super group like Calvin Harris style. Nathan, you've got enough people under your belt now. They're all going to come out on May the 11th.
Well, I know. Who knows? But no, it's going to be an experience, and one that I'm really, you know, proud of and thankful for. And, you know, who knows what can happen, but fingers crossed.
Who? No, I tell you what, if you do win, Anne-Marie, you're going to have to bake him something.
Yes. Celebration cake.
That face, maybe no.
Yeah.
It was fun. It was cool. It was fun to watch.
I actually loved it. Yeah. I just wish that I did a David Baddell and was really bad, so like no one asked me to bake them anything ever.
Is this the thing now? Are you getting like all the texts being like, oh, it's so lovely, you know? I've got a birthday coming up for a 25th. I need it.
Yeah, that's what's happening. So, great. I'm glad I've done that.
I was going to say, hey, I did Millionaire Shortbread for the first time last week and I didn't kill anyone. So I think we're on a good start.
Wow.
Sorry, it's not sorry about it. Let's do a bake-off between all of us. Anne-Marie, I need to ask you, album, when, what's it called? Can I buy it on a cassette?
Yeah, you can.
Yes!
I have put, they've all gone to the mix. Mm-hmm. They've all gone to the master. Mm-hmm. I've got one left to master, and then the album is done.
Wow.
I'm not telling you the date. I'm not telling you the name, but fine. You can get it on cassette.
Can I have? Oh, get it on VHS at this rate, mate. Are you really happy with it? Are you proud of it?
Yeah, I'm so happy. I think it goes to what we were saying earlier. We've had so much more time to be creative, and it's such a good feeling, because when you're on tour and you're so busy, it's almost like you feel like a bit of a fraud, because you're like, the time you spend in the studio and what you're thinking about, it's like, I've always wanted to give music a bit more time, but we just never have had it. So this year is given us that, you know. I've actually concentrated and I've been there every step of the way, through every mix, hearing every little instrument. I've been really OCD with it.
I was gonna say, that would drive you insane.
I think my label love me now.
She went from like a C+ to an A-star student in a year.
Yeah.
Thanks,
but Kobe. It's coming and I'm really excited. It's really heartfelt, but there's also some bangers on there, so it's a mixture of everything.
I'm so excited. I'm excited for you too. I feel like this is such a beautiful little match. And I'm just so excited for summer, for you guys to just be like, Nathan, I just want you behind a deck. Like,
So do I. I think I just want to be in Ibiza Rocks, like with this Ciroc flowing, and just, performing this tune would be the dream.
Let's charter it. Let's get it done. Right, you two, I'm going to let you go. Thank you so much for hanging out, as always. Good to see you both.